In February 2023, Segirinya and Sewanyana petitioned the Constitutional Court, arguing that their separate trials in different courts amounted to an abuse of the court process and political persecution. They also filed an application in the International Crimes Division, seeking to halt their trial until the constitutional petition is resolved. The legislators claimed that their application to consolidate the cases was dismissed and no progress was made by the Director of Public Prosecutions to commence the trial. They also expressed concern over the Director of Public Prosecutions' actions, stating they were inconsistent and in contravention of the Constitution, which led them to file a constitutional petition. However, the International Crimes Division of the High Court, presided over by Justice Alice Komuhangi, dismissed the two MPs' application, saying it lacks merit. Justice Komuhangi advised the two legislators to wait for the Constitutional Court decision rather than halting the ongoing processes.
This court has previously made decisions on the issue of consolidation of the matter before this court and the matter in the Masaka Court. It has also made a decision in respect of restricted disclosures, a detailed decision. It also made a detailed decision on the application for constitutional reference. And in all those decisions, this court made detailed gave detailed reasons.
In court, MP Muhammad Segirinya asked the court to give him more time to get treatment, which the court agreed to.
Thank you, Your Worship. Thank you very much, Your Worship.
The matter was adjourned to 24th of October 2023. Segirinya and Alan Sewanyana and several others are indicted with several counts of murder and terrorism in relation to the 2021 wave panga wielding murders. Report compiled by Rachel Nachiwala. For the news.